Hello everybody, my name is Masoud, and in this video I'm gonna teach you how you can use Codepush library to update your application without sending any APK to App Store and waiting for app checking process. And in this way you can immediately update your app for your customers. Maybe you have generated some bugs in your application and you don't want your customers see that, and you immediately can update your app without sending any APK to your App Store. In this video I'm gonna teach you how you can implement Codepush into your existing React Native project. I'm gonna use this library, React Native Codepush. It's a very, very good library that we can use it to implement Codepush in our project. And also for sample, I'm using React Native GitHub Client. It's one of my open source projects. It's really simple. It just has three pages that you can log in into your GitHub account, and then you can write a repository name, submit it, and then you are able to see the, I think, 30 last commits of that repository. So let's begin. Okay, here is list of things that we should do. At first we should use and install Codepush CLI, because it's really useful for running commands like deploying a new bundle for our application, or maybe register, logout, login, see the result, how many users have installed the new version, or and other things. So let's go ahead and install this library. At first I'm installing it globally to be able to use it in all my projects. Okay, now we should use Codepush, and you can see all the commands that you can run. For example, here we have register a new mobile center account. We need definitely it, and could push register, and your browser will be open, and you should register into Visual Studio App Center. I'm using my Google account. It will ask you the username. I want to be like something like this, and I should copy this token and then paste it here. So now we are successfully logged in, and we can use Codepush. The next step is defining our application into our Codepush account. So I should run this command, Codepush app add. We're gonna add a new application, and here is the name of our application. I'm gonna name it MyGit. Because the project is a Git client somehow, and the platform is Android and also React Native, because you can use Codepush also for other libraries. For example, I think you can use it for Ionic or other platforms. Okay. Now we have a production key and staging key. you should save them somewhere because you will need them. And after that, I should install this library, React Native Code Push, to, for example, bundling new changes to update the application. So I'm install it, npm install, dash save, React Native Code Push. After that, we should use link command to link this library into our application. It is necessary, although I'm using React Native newer versions, that it has a feature to link automatically all the dependencies, but React Native Code Push library doesn't support auto linking, so we should do it by ourselves. And you can see that this feature will stop working from next release, but I hope they will fix it. So here you need to insert your code push deployment key that we got in last step. Okay, insert it and hit enter. Okay, and here you can see that the link command has added a string to our resources. It's our deployment key. If you install it and the code push doesn't apply change in your application, you should check this here, this section, to be the same as the deployment key that we've gotten in the last step. And I think everything is ready to go to our app.js file and write a little code to enable code push for our application. So you should use your first JavaScript file, for example, it. But I'm gonna use my app.js file because it's better and I have access to write component did mount. So I will write it here. It's somehow the root file of my project. So at first I should import code push here, and I need a component did mount here. As you can see, I use the sync command. You should use it. If you don't use the sync command, your app will be not updated. And for example, user needs to restart several times the app to see the new version. Don't forget to put this here. Install mode, I defined immediate, but you have another options. For example, on next restart and resume, or on next suspect. It's good for us immediate. And also we should export our app.js class in another way. I removed it away, and I'm gonna first define our options for code push. Code push options, subject, and check frequency. Sorry, again, sorry. Check frequency should be code push dot check frequency dot on application soft. And then also we should another time define install mode to immediate. Code push again, install mode and immediate. And finally, export the class in this way. Export default app equal to code push. It's a high order component. At first, I should pass code push or options. And then for the next component, app. Oh, yeah, or main class, root class. Okay, it was all the things that we should do, and here we can build our application, install it on our emulator, and then we can see the result and test all the things that we should do. Here I'm using npm run build command to build an echo, and then okay, here is our release application. I will drop it here and it will be installed. Now you can see our application. It's a really, really simple GitHub client. You can write a repository name here, touch the submit, and then you can find the last comments of that repository. Now we're gonna update our application. For example, we want to make this button hidden. Now we will go to the code. The button is here. This is the submit button. I'm gonna just comment it. And then everything is ready. I should run this command. Code push release React. And the name of project, my Git and platform. And also we should define that we wanna build it in a production mode. Production. Because code push has two states, one of them is production and other is staging. We wanna do it for production now. We should wait a little. Okay, now you can see that we release our new version, and here I should close it first and reopen it. My Git. And you can see that once I open the application, the button goes hide, and our app successfully updated with the last version. And if I close it and reopen it again, it won't change. So that's enough for today video. You have learned how to use code push to update your applications without waiting for App Store review process, a process that is really time consuming, and you can immediately update your application for our users. Thank you. If you like the video, you can thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to have new videos. Thank you. Goodbye.